I want to welcome everybody. I'm Don Ingber, and Dave Mooney, who's sitting here, and I are welcoming you as the interim co-directors of HIBE, the Harvard Institute for Biologically Inspired Engineering. Dave and I were asked to co-chair a working group by the provost to explore the future of bioengineering across the whole university. This activity has been below the radar screen for now almost 4 years. The working group came to realize there's really a paradigm shift going on. There's a merging of engineering with the physical sciences and life sciences. And as a result, the boundaries between living and non-living systems are literally beginning to break down. And so what we envision is what we call biologically inspired engineering. By gaining inspiration from the life sciences and how nature works, we'll develop entirely new engineering solutions that will transform medicine as well as industry and the environment. The success of this will be measured in terms of not only papers, but also intellectual property, products, corporate partnering, licensing. This is really going to be launching over the next few months and growing at, we hope, exponential rates.
We're bringing to market Wyss-developed technology to treat opioid-exposed newborns with a unique vibrating mattress.
Using technology developed partly at the Wyss, we provide biomarker detection strategies to better understand the tumor microenvironment.
The Wyss Institute was able to de-risk the development of a soft robotic exosuit. It allowed us to bring the product to market more quickly, more efficiently, and get it available to patients.
Rett syndrome is a severe form of autism that affects 1 in 9,000 women. There is no cure. We are developing high-throughput cognitive screening systems to develop effective therapeutics.
We're scanning nature for the microbes that have ability to eat plastic and synthetically evolve them so that they can eat it fast enough to solve the global plastic waste problem.
This enzymatic platform that we're developing is absolutely going to revolutionize the way that RNA and DNA and oligonucleotides will be manufactured and used to make new therapeutic modalities.
The resources and mentorship provided at the Wyss helped our team spin out to bring regenerative 3D printed tissue grafts to patients.
We're really trying to do something different. We're trying to focus on high risk projects. We have the ability to recruit faculty. We have the ability to recruit technical experts from industry and bring them together around some specific challenges. Really trying to build up the community of people who are excited about trying to change things. I think you can see that this is really unique. We're looking 20, 30 years ahead. We really think this is going to be the future.
The future of the Wyss is empowering our scientists and engineers to realize their full potential by allowing them to create groundbreaking technologies.
The future of the Wyss is finding solutions to the most pressing problems in healthcare and sustainability.
The future of the Wyss is improving the health and quality of life for countless people around the world.
The future of the Wyss is in the strength and courage of our entire community.
An ecosystem of collaborative institutions, partners, and philanthropists.
To tackle tough challenges together.
The future of the Wyss is as limitless as our imagination.